Welcome to Food Dialogues, dialogues with food and about food. Travel today has become an inherent part of all our lives. Work, visit to our parental homes, festivities and celebrations in our hometown and villages, and of course, the curiosity to discover new places makes us travel all around the world. There are different modes of travel, quick, slow, whatever. Travel is always enjoyable. Apart from this excitement that we feel while traveling, one thing that we have to keep in mind is safety of food during travel. Today, I'm going to bring to you a wonderful travel food, which is in fact an ancient traditional dish of Tambaram community in Tamil Nadu. It is actually a naivedya that is offered to Lord Varadaraja in the quaint town of Kanchipuram. Yes, you have guessed it right. What we are going to see today is a Kanchipuram idli. You can call it as a Kanchipuram idli or the Kanchipuram idli as it is colloquially known as. What's so special about this Kanchipuram idli that makes it a wonderful travel food? This idli, once cooked, it can remain, its shelf life is 24 to 72 hours at room temperature, even when the outside temperature soars to about 40 degrees centigrade. Isn't it great? Let's now take a look at the ingredients. The basic ingredients required for the preparation of this idli is uda dal, raw rice and parboiled idli rice. I've taken 200 grams each, equal quantities, equal measures of the dal and the two rices. Now the pre-preparation. We're going to wash the rice, both the rices together and the uda dal separately. Wash it well and soak it in enough water for about 4 hours. After 4 hours, you'll have to begin the grinding process. You can do it in a mixie or in a grinder. Now the uda dal has to be ground first into a soft, fluffy paste by sprinkling water. And both the rice together will be ground into a coarse paste. Now I'm going to soak it, grind it, and get back to you with the batter, and we will continue with the recipe. Now the batter is ready. I had washed all the ingredients, the dal and the rice, ground it separately into a coarse paste, and then I fermented it for 6 hours. You can see how well the batter has fermented thanks to the Leuchenostock microbes and the other microorganisms which has resulted in this kind of fermentation. Now to this, we are going to add more ingredients to make it flavorful. I'm going to add a little bit of salt, asafoetida, jeera and pepper, 1 teaspoon each, 1/2 cup of gingerly oil, 1/4 cup of ghee, ginger and curry leaves, 1 cup of fresh curd. Now you see that with all these ingredients, the batter has become even more lighter and slightly thinner in consistency. Now once you add all the ingredients, you will have to beat the batter well so that there is more air incorporation. We'll have to take care of that because here in this idli, the dal and the rice are in equal proportion. So there is a possibility of the idli becoming dense and hard. So in order to avoid that, this kind of whisking is very, very important. Once this is done, I'm now going to add just 1 pinch of cooking soda. This will help us to get a very soft idli. Let's give this a mix. Now the interesting part about this idli is you can mold it in any shape that you like. Generally, for consumption at home, I use these small tumbler-like molds. I also use the regular tumblers and cut it into round slices when required. And for travel, I generally pack it up this way. This is a eco-friendly, disposable cup. I have oiled it and I insert a banana leaf into it. And then I spoon in the idli batter. This is also greased. Now, what's so special about this banana leaf? If you take a look at our ancestral way of eating, our ancestors ate only on banana leaves. Banana leaves have a component known as the polyphenol oxidase. And this polyphenol oxidase has got a lot of anti-aging properties. And apart from that, the chlorophyll in the banana leaf and the inherent flavor of the leaf gets added on to the idli. So now we are going to insert this into a steaming cooker. I'm using a rice cooker, a steamer. And as I have told you earlier in my idli video, care has to be taken to see that the steamer is hot enough. So now let's insert this into the steamer. The steam has built up well in the steamer. So now I'm going to insert the idlis for steaming. Please do it carefully so that you don't burn your hands. Now this idli will take a longer time when compared to our usual idlis. So we'll have to allow it to steam for about 20 to 30 minutes. So let's wait before we are able to see the Kanchipuram idlis, and we will probably begin to eat it too. So now I think the idlis are ready. It's a good 30 minutes of steaming. I'm going to insert a fork, and the fork has come out clean. Super soft Kanchipuram idlis for you to eat at home or to carry with you during travel, with all the super ingredients, pepper, jeera, ginger, curry leaves, is all there now ready for you to eat.